y of x be solution of x square y double dash minus 2y equal to 0, y of 1 equal to 1, y of 2 equal to 1. Then the value of y of 3. This we have to find out. Now, so here we have to find the solution. For that, so this equation, we know that Cauchy-Euler ODE is of the form x square y double dash plus alpha y dash plus beta y equal to 0. This ODE is called Cauchy-Euler ODE, and corresponding auxiliary equation is of the form r square plus alpha minus 1 r plus beta is equal to 0. So this is the auxiliary equation, and solution is of the form, suppose auxiliary equation has root r1 r2, then solution is of the one c1 x raised to r1 plus c2 x raised to r2. Now here the equation given x square y double dash minus 2y equal to 0. Therefore, it is a Cauchy-Euler equation, and here alpha equal to 0 and beta equal to minus 2. Therefore, aux equation implies r square alpha is 0. 0 minus 1 minus r plus minus 2 is equal to 0. So, the solution, if this is a quadratic equation, if you find the solution, then r equal to 2 minus 1. Therefore, the solution is of the form C1 x plus C2, C1 x square plus C2 x raised to minus 1. Now, given, we have given some condition. y of 1 equal to 1 and y of 2 equal to 1. So given y of 1 equal to 1, y of 2 equal to 1. Now solving. By using initial condition, we will get C1 equal to 1 by 7 and C2 equal to 6 by 7. Therefore, y equal to 1 by 7 x square plus, if you use this equation, you will get the value of C1 and C2 plus C2. C2 is 6 by 7. 6 by 7 into 1 by x inverse. Therefore, y of 2 is equal to 1 by 7 into 2 square. Sorry, we have to find out y of 3. So y of 3 is equal to 1 by 7 into 3 square plus 6 by 7 into 1 by 3. If you calculate this, you will get 33 by 21, which is equal to 11 by 7. So the option 11 by 7, is there is any option? Yes, therefore option number 4 is correct. Next problem. The positive values of lambda for which the equation y double dash x plus lambda square y equal to 0 has non-trivial solution satisfying y of 0 is equal to y of pi and y dash of 0 equal to y dash of pi are, these are the options. Now this is a Sturm-Lovely problem. Sturm-Lovely problem with the periodic boundary condition. Boundary condition. Now, okay. Now, so here y double dash plus lambda y is equal to 0 is the equation. Now corresponding auxiliary equation is r square plus lambda is equal to 0, lambda square, right? Lambda square is equal to 0, which implies r equal to plus or minus I lambda. Therefore y is of the form a cos lambda x plus b sin lambda x. So this is it. So here unknowns are a and b. So we have given y of 0 equal to y of pi. So which implies if we put 0 here, you will get a is equal to cos 0 is 1 and sin 0 is equal to 0. A cos lambda pi plus b sin lambda pi, which implies a into 1 minus cos lambda pi plus b into sin lambda minus b into sin lambda pi is equal to 0. So this is first equation. And for second equation we have y dash of 0 is equal to y dash of pi, which implies y dash of first you find out y dash is equal to lambda a minus lambda a sin lambda x plus lambda b cos lambda x. So this y dash of 0 you will get lambda b is equal to minus lambda a sin lambda pi plus lambda b cos lambda pi. So which implies b lambda and lambda you can get cancelled. So you will get b into 1 minus cos lambda pi plus sin lambda pi is equal to 0. So this is a second equation, and solving first and second equation 1 and 2 is A into 1 minus cos lambda pi minus b sin lambda pi is equal to 0. A sin lambda pi, here there is a sin lambda pi minus b into 1 minus cos pi lambda pi is equal to 0. So this is a system of equation 2 by 2 system. It has a non-trivial solution if and only if determinant of 1 if and only if determinant of 1 minus cos lambda pi minus sin lambda pi sin lambda pi minus 1 minus here it is plus, right? 1 plus 1 minus cos lambda pi, this equal to 0. So this determinant equal to 0, by solving this if and only if 1 minus cos lambda pi is equal to 0, which implies cos lambda pi is equal to 1. This happens only when lambda is equal to 2n, plus or minus 2n. Here we have positive solutions. So here lambda equal to 2n, this is the answer. So here lambda is equal to 2n. The second option is correct. Three question. Consider the PDE. P of xy, dou square u by dou x square plus e raised to x square, e raised to y square, dou square u by dou x dou y plus q of xy, dou square u by dou y square plus e raised to x, dou u by dou x, e raised to y, dou u by dou y equal to 0, where p and q are polynomials in two variables with real coefficients. Then, which of the following is true for all choices of P and Q? First one, there exists R greater than 0 such that PDE is elliptic in this set. And second option, there exists R greater than 0 such that PDE is hyperbolic. And R greater than 0 such that PDE is parabolic in this set. And there exist R greater than 0 such that PDE is hyperbolic in this. But we know that in general a PDE of the form a PDE of the form A dou square u by dou x square plus B dou square u by dou x dou y plus C dou square u by dou y square is equal to some f of x y is hyperbolic if discriminant b square minus 4ac is greater than 0 and elliptic if discriminant less than 0 and parabolic if this discriminant equal to 0. So now here I will take an example. If I take P of xy equal to x square plus y square plus 100 and q of xy equal to 1. Both are polynomials in two variables. So we have in this question, what is discriminant? In this question, discriminant delta is equal to e raised to x square into e raised to y square all square minus P of xy into q of xy. So we can check what will happen. So here discriminant is equal to e raised to, this you can write written as e raised to 2 into x square plus y square minus p into q. Now, what is p and q in this example? E raised to 2 into x square plus y square minus x square plus y square plus 100. First, I am not taking this 100 only. This means x square plus p equal to x square plus y square. So this is a polynomial and this is 1. Now, this is for this case, this is always greater than 0, therefore nowhere elliptic. There does not exist any r such that, doesn't exist any r such that this positive, negative. So this is always greater than 0. So option number 1 is wrong. Now what about option number 3? I'm taking 3, third option. Third option is there exists r greater than 0 such that PDE is parabolic. So here this parabolic means discriminant is equal to 0, which implies e raised to 2 x square plus y square is equal to x square plus y square. But this never equals. So option 3 is not equal, not true. That is, this option is false. Now what about fourth option? Fourth option, here for fourth option I am taking another example. P equal to, here I am taking x square plus y square plus 100 and q is equal to 1. Then discriminant is equal to e raised to 2 into x square plus y square minus x square plus y square plus 100. So what is fourth option? Fourth option tells us there exists r greater than 0 such that PDE is hyperbolic in more x square plus y square less than r. Now here if x square plus y square less than r, here if I take x y equal to 0 0, then what happened here? E raised to 0 minus this will 100, this is always less than 0. That means for any r greater than 0, this condition is not true. So fourth option is also false. So the only option is second option. So this is the next problem. 44 question. Let u be the unique solution of dou u by dou t, dou square u by dou x square, where x t belongs to first interval open 0, 1 into cross 0 infinity, u of 0 x is equal to sine pi x, u of 0 t is equal to u 1 t is equal to 0. Then which of the following options is true? First one, there exists x t such that u of x t is equal to 0. Second one, there exists x t such that u dou u by dou t is equal to 0. Third one, there exists function e raised to t into u of x t is bounded for x t belongs to open 0, 1 cross 0 infinity. Fourth one, there exists x t belongs to open 0, 1 in cross 0 infinity such that u of x t greater than 1. Now solution. So solution of one dimensional heat equation on finite rod, that is dou u by dou t is equal to c square dou u square by dou x square, u of on a finite rod of length L, u of 0 t is equal to 0, u of l t is equal to 1, u of x0 is equal to f of x is solution is u of x t is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x pi l into e raised to minus n square c square pi square t pi l. So this is the solution. Now here our rod is a finite rod. Here dou u by dou t is equal to dou square u by dou x square, and here c equal to 1. So c equal to 1 and l equal to 1. Therefore here solution is of the form u of x t. So solution of this PDE wave equation is of the form u of x t is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x into e raised to minus n square pi square t. So this is the solution. Now we want to find out bn. Also we have given u of x0 is equal to, here what is u of x0? Sin pi x. Sin pi x. Here we have given u of x0 is equal to sin pi x. Okay. And also, u of x t, we know that we already find out u of x t is sigma n equal to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x e raised to minus n square pi square t. Now equating this both. Okay, here u of x0 is equal to sin pi. This is equation number 1. And from here, what is u of x0? Sigma n equal to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x e raised t0, therefore into 1. Thus, this is equation number 2. Equating 1 and 2. So here u of x0 is sin pi x is equal to, here it is when n equal to 1, b1 sin pi x plus b2 sin 2 pi x plus etc. So by equating the coefficient, weighting coefficient, we get b1 is equal to 1, so here 1, and b2 equal to b3 equal to etc. equal to 0, all other terms are 0. Therefore our u of xt, our solution is of the form sin pi x into e raised to minus n is 1 pi square t. So this is our solution. Now what are the options? Options are, first option, there exists xt in open 0 1. Open 0 1 into 0 infinity u of x t 0. So we will check that. So here this u of x t is equal to 0 if this sin pi x is equal to 0. So sin pi x is 0 if cannot be 0 in open interval 0. X belongs to open interval 0, 1, sin pi x not equal to 0. Thus, this u of x t not equal to 0 for every x t belongs to open 0, 1, cross 0, infinity. Therefore, option 1 is wrong. Option 1 is not wrong. So you can cancel out this. This is not true. Now next is dou u by dou t. So that is also similar. Okay. So u of x t is this. Then what is dou u by dou t? This is equal to sin pi x into minus pi square e raised to minus pi square t. By similar argument as above, this cannot be equal to 0 on 0, 1 on x t belongs to 0, 1 cross 0, infinity. Because this is a 0 only when x is an integer. So here there is no integer here. Okay, so option 2 is also wrong. Option 2 is also wrong. Now I am taking option 4. Is it greater than 1 for any xt? So what is u of xt? We have u of x t is equal to, for option 4, sin pi x e raised to minus pi square t. Now we have mod u of x t is always less than or equal to mod sin pi x e raised to minus pi square t. We know that mod pi is always less than or equal to 1. Therefore, this is always less than or equal to minus pi square t. And this quantity, as t is greater than 0, this quantity is always less than 1. So, there is no xt such that u of xt greater than 1. So, option 4 is also wrong. So option 4 is also wrong. So the only option 3 is correct. T be the curve which maximizes the functional j of x is equal to integral 0 to 1 x square of t plus x dash square of t dt, satisfying x of 0 equal to 0, x of 1 equal to 1. Then the value of x star of 1 by 2 is. So, we want to find out the maximum. So, solution, we know that Cauchy-Euler equation is f derivative of x minus d by dt of f x dash is equal to 0. So this equation is called Cauchy-Euler equation, and here the integrand f is equal to x square plus x dash square. Now this equation number 1 implies, and under taking derivative with respect to x, then 2x plus d by dt of derivative of x dash or square is 2 into x dash is equal to 0 minus, which implies 2x minus 2x dash square. Sorry, 2x double dash, derivative of x dash is x double dash. So which implies you can cancel out 2 and 2 and multiplying with minus 1, you will get x double dash minus x equal to 0. So this solution, so what is auxiliary equation? R square minus 1 equal to 0, which implies r equal to plus or minus 1. Therefore, x equal to, the solution is of the form c1 e raised to x plus c2 e raised to minus x. Now we have given the initial condition x of 0 is equal to 0 and x of 1 equal to 1. Now we will apply in equation number. In this equation we will get, applying the this condition here, we will get c1 is equal to 1 by e plus 1 and c2 is equal to e by e plus 1. Therefore, x equal to 1 by e plus 1 or x star is equal to 1 by e plus 1 e raised to x plus e by e plus 1 e raised to minus x. So which implies x star of 1 by 2, if you put here, you will get 2 root e by 1 plus e. So this answer is correct. Seventh question. If y is a solution of integral equation y of x is equal to integral 0 to x minus t y of t dt equal to 1, then which of the following is true? First one, y is bounded but not periodic in R. Second one, y is periodic in R. Third one, integral over R y of x dx less than infinity. And fourth one, integral over R dr by dx by y of x less than infinity, that is one. So here solution, so this is an integral equation. Given integral equation y of x equal to y of x minus integral 0 to 0 to x minus t y of t dt is equal to 1. Now here we take Laplace transform, because this is in the form of a convolution theorem. F star of t g of x is equal to integral 0 to x f of x minus t g of t dt. This form, this is called convolution. So now I am taking Laplace transform of 1, you will get L of y minus L of integral 0 to x minus t y of t dt is equal to L of 1. So Laplace transform of y, I am taking y of s minus Laplace transform of this convolution of 0 to x, this must be, you know that this L of this is equal to so convolution property L inverse of f of s into g of s is equal to convolution of f star g, where f of s is L of f of t, and g of s is L of g of t. So here the Laplace transform of this is equal to, therefore L of f star g t is f of s into f of t g of s. So this is equal to, this is of the form f of x minus t, so f of x. So the Laplace transform of x is 1 by s square into Laplace transform of y is y of s is equal to Laplace transform of 1 is 1 by s. So if you take y of s common, 1 minus 1 by s square is equal to 1 by s. So y of s is into s square minus 1 divided by s square equal to 1 by s. S and s get cancelled. So I will get y of s is equal to 1 by s square minus 1. Now I want y of t. This is equal to L inverse of y of s, which is equal to L inverse of 1 by s square minus 1. So the L inverse of 1 by s square minus 1 is cos h t. So our y of t is equal to cos h t, which is equal to e raised to t plus e raised to minus t divided by 2. Now I will check what are the options. First one is y is bounded. Y is bounded. So this is not bounded. Not bounded. So first option is wrong. Second, y is periodic. This function is not periodic. Periodic. So this option is cos h t is not. Not periodic. And what about this? Now integral minus infinity to infinity e raised to t plus e raised to minus t by 2 dt. This goes to infinity because e raised to t by t goes to infinity. So this also wrong. So the only option correct is fourth option.